Companies don't need manual analysis. We can just send a sample to an antivirus company and you will cover it for them. I got this comment from someone and it's actually not really true. So here's the thing. When you send the sample to an antivirus company, they wouldn't analyze it for you. They will actually do include it in their signature and that's it. They may update the signature, but that doesn't cover everything related to the malware. The thing here is that not only that you will not know what are the domains to cover and what are all the other different IOCs that you can detect infected machines with, you also send them one sample from your machine. You don't know if there's any other samples that actually part of that malware, maybe a dropper, maybe a downloader that's already in other machines as well. The second thing is that companies can actually do the analysis for you if you pay for that. It's a completely different package. They can do the whole incident response process, but that's a third package. And companies would prefer to have that in-house rather than paying for all of these companies every single time. But even it's not only because it's money-wise it is better, but also for them it is much better as a time-wise, because until you send the sample and actually react for a case like ransomware, you might have the whole company has been encrypted by the time when the antivirus company reacted. And you need to have something that is fast and timely manner that you can detect this malware, and not only detect the malware and analyze it or understand what it does, understand or collect at least the IOCs, but also to know what are all the other what are all the other files have been dropped by this malware have been used, what is the root cause, how that happened and how it came to this machine, and last, to be able to contain and remediate this attack. And that means to know all the infected systems, where this malware, even one stage of this malware is actually there, and able to remediate this attack. And this is a bigger process than just analyzing the malware. Last thing is that malware analysis, the knowledge that you learn with malware analysis, is the core fundamentals of learning any part of malware of cybersecurity. The reason is that malware analysis is actually covering the how real attacks look like. This is important for offensive, for defensive, for the defensive side. There's actually a book that I was reading, that I was looking into like a few days ago, and it's called Advanced Penetration Testing, Hacking the World with Most Secure Networks. And what it talks about, all the books talking about generating malware. That's all what it talks about. How to generate a spear phishing email, how to generate different malware, and how you can escalate through the whole attack. The real thing is that real attacks, real targeted attacks, that what's happening in the wild and what is hacking the world's most secure networks are all depending on malware. All depending on the malware behavior, malware functionality, and specific techniques to escalate privilege, to do the lateral movements, to maintain resistance, and so on. So if you understand malware analysis, you understand how all these attacks happen. This is the core knowledge that from there you can go into in whatever the field you want. For penetration testing, how I can simulate these attacks. If you are in the threat hunting, what type of techniques or tactics I can predict and try to defend against it. If I am in threat intelligence, then how I can use IOCs to collect and to track specific actors that comes into shared code, that comes into shared IOCs, and that lots of work is related to malware analysis. And last, and how to respond to an attack, which is mainly based on malware analysis and malware knowledge. So this is why malware analysis is still very relevant to lots of companies who want to protect themselves and to people who want to find a job in that field. Hope that video is helpful for you, and see you in the next video.